So here I am, back at the code, and here I can see my class movie, and within it, I will begin to define the function init. Now, there is something very curious about this function already, which is that there are two underscores on both sides of the word init. These underscores are a way for Python to tell us, the programmers, that hey, the name init is essentially reserved in Python, and that this is a special function or method. What's special about init is that it initializes or creates space in memory to remember details like title, storyline, etc. for new movies that we are about to create. Now, init takes a few pieces of information or arguments, the first of which is always the Python keyword self. Now, what is this thing called self, you ask? Well, you can think of self as itself or the instance being created. So when we run this line of code in our other Python file, by the way, just to remind you, here we are trying to create a new movie called Toy Story. And when we run this line of code, we know that the init function inside the class movie gets called. Self in that case points to Toy Story. Now here, I have a confession to make. I remember when I was first learning object-oriented programming years ago in college, this concept of self was really difficult for me to understand. If that is the case with you, don't worry about it too much for now. This will get really clear when we run this entire piece of code in a few seconds. In any case, let's add the keyword self to our list of new words. Okay, I'm going to go back to the class movie and continue to define the function init. Now we want init to initialize pieces of information like title, storyline, and others that we want to remember inside our class. Here's a way to do that. I will say self.title, then self.storyline. The next one is poster image URL. And finally, trailer YouTube URL. Now we have to somehow initialize these variables with information init is going to receive. And in particular, it's going to receive four pieces of information. The first of which is a movie title. Next is the movie storyline. Then the poster image of the movie. And finally, the trailer on YouTube. So get this, once I've received these four pieces of information as arguments to the init function, I can initialize my movie variables. Here's how to do that. Self.title is the movie title. Self.storyline is the movie storyline. Next is the poster image. And finally, the trailer on YouTube. Now here, I have a confession to make, which is that we've written a lot of code that looks new and strange. Well, the one thing I can say is that we should all just take a pause and a deep breath together. For now, all I want you to do is pause this video and write down this code on your computer. All of this code will make sense as soon as we run this program. Now, there is one key point I would like to highlight before I execute this piece of code, which is that if I go to my other Python file, which is entertainmentcenter.py, and run this piece of code, it will throw an error. The error will happen because when we try to create the movie Toy Story, the init function gets called, which is now looking for several arguments or pieces of information, although we are not sending it any information whatsoever. So let me change that. Now, I know that the first argument for the init function is self, which is added by default in Python, so I will skip it. The next one is movie title, which I know is Toy Story, so I will add that. After that is the movie storyline, so I will type that in next. A story of a boy and his toys that come to life. The next one is the poster image, so I will add that. I had previously gone on to Wikipedia and found a link to Toy Story's poster, so I added that. And finally, the YouTube trailer, which I will add also. There it is. Now let me just scroll back so we can see the beginning of the code. Here I recognize that you can't see all of the code, so what I've done is taken an image of the code and put it in the instructor notes for you to look at. All right, the last thing I'm going to do here is print Toy Story's storyline. Let me save this file and then go back to my class movie file and save that one also. And then come back again to my entertainmentcenter.py file. Now here, if everything goes correctly, my program should print out Toy Story Storyline. Let's run it. And there it is. Toy Story Storyline is getting printed. Okay, so in the next video, we are going to see what happens behind the scenes when we run this piece of code.